In this chapter, we'll load our sample project, add some holograms to the scene, and then we'll deploy that project to the Hololens emulator. You can find the sample project at the link below. First, we'll launch Unity. At the top, click Open, and then browse to the folder where you extracted the starter project. Then click Select Folder. Go to the File menu, click Save Scene As, and name your scene Origami. Now we're going to update our camera to be a holographic camera. Click on the main camera on the left in the hierarchy. We're going to do two things to the camera. We're going to change its position to be at the origin, and we're going to change its clear color so that it clears to black. Everything that renders as black will be transparent when viewed in the device. First, go over to position and change Y to 0 and Z to 0. Go down to clear flags, set it to solid color, and then click the background and change that to black. Over in the hierarchy panel on the left, click create and then do create empty. This creates a new game object that we're going to put our other scene objects in. Rename this object by right-clicking and saying rename, and name the object Origami Collection. Now, on the bottom in the project pane, click on the Holograms folder. This contains a set of pre-built assets that we're going to use to bring art into our application. Go ahead and take the stage object and drag it directly into Origami Collection. And you'll see it appears as a child if you've dragged correctly. Drag sphere 1 and sphere 2 to be children of Origami Collection in the same way. Next, we'll add some lighting that will make our holograms look great. Click on the directional light and then right-click and delete it. Take the lights asset and drag it into the root of the scene by dropping it in the empty area. Next, let's move the Origami Collection so it appears in front of the user. Click on the Origami Collection and change its position to 0 for X, minus 0.5 for Y, and 2.0 for Z. This will put it 0.5 meters below the user's head and 2 meters in front of the user's head when the app starts. You can click Play at the top of the scene to preview what this will look like. Click Play again to stop. Go up to the File menu and click Build Settings. Choose Windows Store, and then under SDK, choose Universal 10. For the build type, select Direct3D, and then check off the box that says Unity C# Projects. Now, make sure you click Add Open Scenes in order to add the current scene to our project. Click Build at the bottom, and now we choose where we're going to place the Visual Studio project that Unity will generate. Click New Folder to add a new folder, and let's call it App. With that folder selected, go ahead and click Select Folder at the bottom. Unity will now generate the Visual Studio project that we'll use to build and then deploy to our device. Once the project's been generated, open the App folder and double-click on the Origami solution. To deploy to the device, let's first set our configuration to Release, set the target to x86, and then on the Play menu, pull it down and choose Hololens Emulator. Now, go ahead and click on the play button to deploy to the emulator. When the emulator loads, you'll see your scene in the window. Any pixels that show up black here will show the real world on a HoloLens. In this chapter, we saw how to make our scene holographic, how to add objects to the scene that will appear as holograms, and how to deploy that scene to our device. In the next chapters, we're going to figure out how to add interactivity to the objects by using gaze, gesture, and voice.